In today's class, we will discuss about hot wire anemometer, or we can call it as thermal method. This hot wire anemometer will find the rate of flow in a given instrument. Okay, so how much volume of liquid is coming or fluid is coming from the given instrument? So it will find the discharge Q value, meter cube per second. How much volume is coming, meter cube of water or liquid is coming per unit time. Or we can write V by T. Volume by time. Units are meter cube by second. So how it will find the discharge Q value? Here, what is the basic principle of it? In it, we are using two methods. One is constant current method, and next one is constant temperature method. There are two methods. We can use either this method or this method. Here, both methods are working on the same basic principle. So here I did one diagram. Before explaining this basic principle, just I will tell. Here flow is going in this direction at input in a given pipe, and flow is coming here. What I am doing is, I am keeping one electric conductor. Electric conductor means which can pass the electricity through it. Okay? If you are sending electricity through this, it is getting heat. Okay, so this is called heated wire. I am keeping heated wire in the flow stream. Initially this temperature is more because of heat we are supplying to it. So during the flow, this flow temperature is less. It will absorb this temperature or heat from the filament. And after absorbing the temperature, this flow is getting heat and this is getting cool. The temperature will be less. Okay, so because of less temperature, the resistance of this wire will also change. Okay, so temperature and resistance are depending on each other. So resistance will also change because of change in temperature. That change in resistance will find the flow. Okay, this is the basic principle. So according to it, the change in resistance of the wire becomes a measure of flow rate. Okay. Now here in our method, we have to find how much change in resistance we have to find it. That will indicate the Q value in the calibrated form. Okay. So here how to change the resistance? Here we are using in two methods, two different forms. So first one is constant current method, and here we are supplying the constant current. And next is constant temperature method. We are keeping the constant temperature of this filament. So here, what is the description of these two methods? Two methods has same arrangement. Here one pipe we are taking, okay. Here also one pipe. And then one Wheatstone bridge we are taking in both cases. This is a galvanometer. And this is a supply. This is a battery for supplying the voltage or current to this Wheatstone bridge. Okay, one element we are keeping here inside the pipe. And in this case also constant temperature method. Here we are taking battery for supplying the current to the Wheatstone bridge. This is a galvanometer. Galvanometer will measure the current value inside this bridge. And one element we are keeping inside the pipe. Here this voltmeter we are connecting to check how much voltage is in this element or in R4 resistance wire. So for that we are connecting voltmeter here. Here before seeing the operation of these two bridges, two methods, we will see what is the working principle of the Wheatstone bridge. Because we are using in two places, so how it is working, Wheatstone bridge. Why we are connecting this Wheatstone bridge to this element? Let us see, I did separately here, Wheatstone bridge. Let us take the Wheatstone bridge, how it is working. First it has four resistance R1, R2. R3, R4. This bridge, this resistance are symmetrical about horizontal axis and vertical axis. Now for supplying the current to this bridge, we are taking the battery here. The amount of current we can control by using the rheostat. By changing the resistance, whatever current we want, we can supply to the bridge. Here, let us take at this after arrangement. Okay, so we know this R1 value, resistance R1, R2 value we know, R3 value we know, R4 we don't know. Let us assume like that. We have to find R4. okay, we are supplying some current, so that in it some, it is showing some current G value. G means galvanometer, it is showing some current, means this amount of current is passing in this circuit. Here what you do means adjust this current so that whatever current inside this galvanometer is zero. Keep this is zero by changing this rheostat. Okay, at that time I is zero is called null position. Okay, at that I zero we can call this bridge is in balanced condition. Balanced condition means the ratio of resistance this side is equal to ratio of this resistance this side, means R1 by R4 is equal to R2 by R3. Ratio of these two resistance is equal to ratio of these two resistance. When it is possible means when the galvanometer reading I is zero. Okay, by using this formula we can find R4. R4 is equal to this side R4 will go, R1 is as it is, into R3 by R2. So this is the main use of this Wheatstone bridge of finding the resistance. Okay, so here we are connecting the coil, whatever coil we are connecting, that temperature of that coil will change the resistance. Let us take the working or operation of the constant current method. In it we took one Wheatstone bridge. We are supplying some current to the Wheatstone bridge with the help of battery and rheostat. Here R1, R2, R3, R4 are the resistance. Okay, because of current supply in this resistance, all are getting heat. Okay, now adjust this rheostat or adjust the current so that G value, whatever galvanometer reading is, it should be zero. I should be zero, means at null position. Okay, so this current is zero now, and here what we are doing means this wire is getting heat. Now next one is supply gas here at input. This gas temperature is less than this coil temperature or wire temperature. This gas will absorb this temperature of the hot wire. So this temperature will getting less, hot wire temperature, because of the flow. This change in temperature will change the resistance also. Okay, this change in resistance, how can we see the change in resistance? Because of unbalanced bridge, because R1, R2, R3, R4 are initially balanced at I zero. So here because of change in resistance, it is showing some unbalanced current, means it is not zero. Okay, whatever value is coming here at the galvanometer, let us assume initially it was zero. Now after getting less temperature, it is showing some value, some 3 amperes, 4 amperes like that. That current, okay, change in current, initially it is zero, now it is 4, 4 minus 0 means 4. That 4 change in temperature will find the rate of flow. Okay, it is a main working operation of this bridge. Here always remember, constant current method means we are not changing this current. Whatever initially at the null position we are giving, we are supplying the same current. We are not changing here. Okay, because of unbalanced bridge, the galvanometer value will be changing. That change in current will give the Q value here. Okay, this is the main working of this bridge or constant current method. Take the next one, constant temperature method. Constant temperature means, remember, this temperature we are maintaining constant. Now take the working operation of this method. In it also we are using the Wheatstone bridge. Here resistance are R1, R2, R3 and R4. Let us take here R4 we are connecting. Now for supply of this bridge we are taking the battery. Some amount of current we are supplying here, and here one pipe arrangement. In it gas is flowing this side and coming this side. Okay, here what we are doing means we are initially keeping, we are giving some current to this bridge at which I is zero, means galvanometer reading is zero. It is called null position. Now this, because of the current, it is getting heat. Okay, now we are supplying gas in this pipe. Because of the less temperature of the gas, this temperature is getting less, because it will transfer the higher heat transferred from higher temperature to lower temperature. The temperature of the filament is getting less. Okay, because of it, resistance will also change. As I told previously, if temperature is changing, means resistance is also changing. Okay, this will show the unbalanced current in this portion. Okay, now do one thing, adjust this rheostat supply current so that G should be zero, means the current in the galvanometer should be zero. Okay, so what we are doing means, if you are adjusting, we are keeping the same resistance as it is, means we are keeping the same temperature as it is. Okay, that's why we are calling constant temperature method. Whatever change in current here we are giving, that change in current will give the rate of flow. Okay, so current, change in current will give rate of flow. Okay, this is the main working operation of this method. Constant temperature means we are keeping the filament temperature constant by changing the supply here. By keeping this G value, means our current is zero, null position we are keeping. Okay, these two methods has little change. One is constant current method, we are supplying, we are not changing here, constant current we are supplying. In this method, we are keeping this temperature constant, we are changing the current here. This is the main difference between these two. Here, no need to write the equations, no need to find R4 also, because by using this galvanometer reading, we can find this flow here. If you want to find R4, how much R4 is, we can write this equation, otherwise it is not necessary. Just for showing, at the null position, the ratio is constant. That's why I have written here like this. And what are the applications of these two methods means? These are in research applications, they are extensively used to study varying flow conditions. And what are the advantages? These are simple arrangements and easy to install. Maintenance is also less and will give a very accurate Q values in both cases. And limitations are, power supply or current supply is necessary for using these meters. Okay, and if you like this lecture, please press the like button and subscribe my channel for more updates.